Hello everyone, what is up? It's your girl. How y'all all doing today? Hope y'all are all having a great day. And you know what I always say, if you're not having a great day, well honey, you better get it together. Today we are going to be furnishing the late night house or loft, whatever you want to call it. I know you guys have been kind of like, I don't know, I you know what's so funny? I know, I'm sorry, I can't form sentences today. I actually had posted something about legacy. I think it was like 3 days ago, maybe. But anyways, I posted legacy on Thursday and you guys were like, bro, isn't late night supposed to be posted on Thursdays? And I'm like, I missed Tuesday because I posted something else on Tuesday. And so I knew somebody was gonna point it out. And I wanna thank you guys first and foremost so much for all your love with the late night series. I feel like you guys just really enjoyed it, which I was super like nervous about the series because I was like, oh God, like what if people don't like it? Because it's the same Sims that they're seeing. I try my best to create new Sims and make things a little bit different. And so because you guys had been seeing Nyla and Maya for such a long time, I thought you guys would really be interested and seeing them again. But I was honestly surprised at how many of you guys really like Kraylin and you really like Malik and the whole gang. And so I was like, yes, like I'm happy that like they actually like them. So yeah, Malik is actually an old Sim. Like I made Malik back when I first started my YouTube channel, and he was in like a create a Sim for like a dance crew that I did. And I always was really in love with the Sim and I always wanted to bring him into a series, but I could never really find the right series to bring him into because Malik has a very different complex than what I used to do. If you guys have been following my channel for a bit, the guy Sims I used to do were completely different than what Malik is like. So I was like, oh, he's not gonna fit in anything. Like he's not gonna fit in the greens, he's not gonna fit in anything. And so I was really happy that I was able to find him and like put him in a series that, you know, he fits in, because I feel like he fits in late night. I don't know, maybe I'm just weird, but today, as I said, I am gonna be furnishing the house. I was really excited to do this because I felt like the house was just kind of bleh. Like, it's a nice loft, but I just felt like it wasn't very personal. I really wanted to make the loft very representative of like all four Sims in the house, and especially like the kitchen, which is where we go to the most, I feel like, in the series, because Nyla likes to cook, and so she would be able to use this kitchen a lot. And this is very different from my usual builds because this is very like party-esque sort of, because I've never really furnished a loft. So I was excited to work with it and see what I could do. So I did end up going with a black and red and white theme for just the living room, or not living room, the kitchen itself. And then I kind of figured out that I wanted sort of a gradient thing, because I really did like the walls in this loft. I thought they were really nice, but I think that they just needed a little bit of an upgrade. So I made it sort of a gradient style in the actual kitchen space. And so you can see that I'm kind of going for darker colors throughout this whole furnishing process. I wanted to do just really dark kind of colors that kind of mesh together. So I mostly went for blacks, whites, threw a little bit of accents of blue in there, and then also red as well. So you can kind of see that I'm throwing that in. And then right here, I'm trying to figure out what the heck I want to do with the flooring. And so you can see there's a lot of long pauses in this video because not only was I doing that, but I was also jamming to some music. So I'm gonna be real, like a lot of pauses that you'll see are just because I am too busy jamming and twerking my booty to some really good hits. Okay, okay, stop. What else did I have to say? Oh yeah, I did want to talk about late night and when it's going to be posted, because a lot of you guys have been like, girl, where's late night out? Post some late night. Where's late night? I will be posting late night from on Thursdays from now on. Now, that doesn't mean that late night's going to be the only thing that I ever post on a Thursday, but if I do post a late night episode, it's going to be on Thursday. And same goes for legacy. If I post a legacy episode, it's most likely going to be on a Tuesday unless I do double videos. So if I do like, I don't know, two videos on a Saturday, and one would be like legacy or late night, and then something else would be like, I don't know, a freaking current household, something like that. You know, that's the only way that I would ever post it on a day when it's not supposed to be. This week was a little bit weird though, because I had a legacy episode pre-recorded, but I didn't have a late night one pre-recorded, and I really wanted to push legacy a little bit and get farther into the episode, so I did post late night on a Thursday instead of a Tuesday, but usually it'll be posted on Tuesdays, and then Saturdays will be for other videos, like decorating videos or current households or freaking, what other videos do I do? Mod reviews, freaking CC showcases, CC shoppings, that kind of stuff. Create a sim with me's. Those will be on Saturdays, and then Tuesday and Thursdays will be late night and legacy. So just in case you guys were curious, that's how it'll go. So if you're wondering when the new late night episode will be coming, Thursday, okay? Thursday. So today is Saturday, so it'll be coming on Thursday. But anyways, as I said, I am working on the kitchen. I'm almost done with it. Actually, the kitchen is probably my favorite part of this house. I really, really think that it is very, it just expresses all four of the Sims in the house really, really well. And it's very urban. I really like just the whole vibe of it. I think it's really nice. So I am happy with the way that it turned out. I realized that as I was building, I didn't really have a lot of money. So I had to kind of steal some stuff from the top floor and kind of work it into the bottom floor. By the way, my voice cracked. That was not cute, hunty. It was not. But anyways, so I had to take some stuff from the top floor and put it on the bottom floor and just kind of work with that. So I'm doing that at the moment and just adding in some chairs. I am obsessed with this little shelf thing. It is actually something that I got just randomly from downloading some type of mod. I don't even know. Maybe it was a house that I downloaded, but it makes really, really good for some nice bar stools or whatever. So I felt like this would be really great to go ahead and put in the house. So I am almost done with the kitchen. Almost there, like so close to being done. This section of the kitchen is actually my favorite part just because I love that York poster. It just looks nice. I really like the graphics of it. So right now I'm working on the barstool area again, trying to figure out exactly what I want to put on this because I don't know, this is the area that they're going to be eating in. Originally I was going to put a full-on table, but just because of the minimal amount of space in this loft, I don't think that there's going to be enough space to really do anything. One thing that I did not do during this build is I didn't do the second floor of the loft because honestly I really did like the second floor of the loft and the way it was furnished. It didn't really bother me too much because we're probably not going to be in there as often. And then another thing that I didn't finish was the bathrooms because I felt like that was just something I could easily do off camera and I didn't really need to show you guys because they're freaking bathrooms, like who cares. But I mostly just did the kitchen and then the three bedrooms in this build. So right now I am doing Malik's room. I think this is Malik's room. I'm pretty sure. I think I got lost in the process of the room building and once I had deleted all the furniture, I was like, oh God, I forgot whose room is whose. So I think this is Malik's. Just for me adding all the furniture. Yeah, that bed is definitely Malik's. I am adding Malik's, doing Malik's room right now. And I don't know if this is his room originally, but it's gonna be his room now because that's how we do. But his room is actually kind of small compared to everybody else's, which I was a little bit, you know, kind of sad about. I felt really bad because Malik's in such a small room and then Maya has a big room and, well, Maya and Kraylin share a room, so it makes sense that they would have a bigger room. But Nyla's is definitely way bigger than Malik's. But right now I'm trying to figure out exactly what I want to do in this room. Honestly, I think Malik's room was probably the hardest to figure out because I don't know. I don't really feel like Malik has any, like anything that's really easy to attach to him, if that makes any sense. I feel like that makes no sense. But like with Maya, it's easy for me to be like, okay, Maya likes fashion design. Maya likes, you know, fashion and all that kind of stuff and girly things, I guess I would say. But it'd be easy for me to take things that Maya likes, like the stylist thing and, you know, maybe some pink accents in the room, just kind of things like that. It'd be easy to take that and be like, okay, this is Maya's room. Nyla too, it's like I could do a bookshelf because she likes to read and she likes science and all that stuff. And then with Kraylin and Malik, it's just kind of like, they're men. Like, they're men. Malik likes drinking and partying and having fun, and Kraylin likes the drums. Like, not really much zest to it, but I mean, whatever. So I ended up just adding some random stuff. Now, can I just say This poster is amazing. I love these posters. They're so, so nice. I don't remember where I got them. Maybe the Sims resource. But that poster says, I was born a king, which I loved. I really wanted to add it into Kraylin's room, but I knew for a fact that Maya was not going to have that. So I went ahead and just put it in Malik's. And I really like the rug too. It's very, very well detailed. I really just like the way that Malik's room ended up in general, because I think his probably took the longest for me to think about, because I was like, oh my God, I don't know where to start. I don't know what to do. We gonna see. And so that's what happened. But anyways, yes, I don't really know what to talk about. I'm so bad at commentary. This is why I don't ever do builds or anything like this, where I like that they're super long, because I feel like this build is going to be really, really long. But let me tell you guys a story. Why not? I'm trying to think of something that would be interesting to tell, because I have so many amazing stories. Okay, let's talk about The Sims 4. Let's talk about The Sims 4. I don't know if you guys have been keeping up with The Sims 4 lately. I don't know if you guys have been like, because a lot of the people that watch me are Sims 3 players. I'm a Sims 3 player myself. I'm so confused as to what's going on with The Sims 4. Like, is it just me, or does it feel like nothing is really happening with the game? Like, it kind of just feels like it's not even a thing anymore. Maybe it's because I'm not really as active in the Sims 4 community as I used to be, because obviously I used to do Sims 4 room builds and those were fine, and I really like doing them. But I feel like when you don't have passion for what you're playing, it's just not as fun. So I just kind of cut off the Sims 4 in general. That's not the point. The point is that I am very confused, because it seems like to me, the Sims 4 team hasn't really been like, is there even an expansion pack or like a stuff pack or anything that's supposed to be released? I haven't heard anything. Maybe it's because I'm not on social media enough. It just kind of feels like they just went MIA. The last thing that I heard that was announced from The Sims 4 was pets, I think. Seasons. I don't know if pets or seasons came first. I don't know. I don't keep up with Sims 4. But it feels like when those happened, I was consistently hearing about it. But I just feel like everything in The Sims 4 has now kind of been hushed. So I don't know if there's new stuff coming out. And I don't know if it's just me, but it seems like it's taken them a really long time to come out with stuff. Like, is it just me, or does it feel like The Sims 4 has been out forever? Like, I don't know why. I feel like The Sims 4 has been out for a very long time, and yet there's been nothing that's been like, oh my God. Like, I'm so excited. Maybe it just, I don't know. It's so weird. I just feel like I'm not as hype about it as I used to be for Sims when I was a kid. And I still love The Sims. I really wish that they would come out with some Sims 3 stuff. Like, I get so hype whenever I see a mod creator or a CC person still making Sims 3 content. It makes me so happy. But anyway, so right now I am working on Maya and Kraylin's room, and this room is pretty cute. Like, I ain't gonna lie. I hate to toot my own fiddle, but I'ma do it. Toot toot, okay? It is cute. And right now I'm actually working on the desk area. Now this area, I feel like I kind of dedicated more towards Maya. That's why it has like all the flashy lights and all that stuff, because I'm gonna be real, like, this is just very Maya. I feel like this whole room is very Maya, with like little hints of Kraylin here and again. But I feel like Maya may be the dominant in the relationship, not gonna lie. So I definitely did kind of make that shown in the room. Not to be mean, but I'm just saying. Anyways, so speaking of The Sims 4, I just got a notification for an update of The Sims 4. Like, I play it. Like, why do I need to update it? I don't even play the game. But anyways, so yeah, I am adding this stuff here. I remember this actually being in The Sims 4, like these lights and stuff. I think somebody had converted them into The Sims 4. But yeah, so I am now putting the shelves in, which I also put in Malik's room. And now we are about to work on Nyla's room. Now, can I just say, you guys see like how much bigger the other rooms are compared to Malik's? Like, Malik's is so small, so small. And I feel so bad for him, but it's like, I mean, what can you do? Like, I can't expand your room, so get over it. But anyways, I did try to take a little bit of space out of Maya's room, so it didn't seem like Malik's was too small, or not Maya. I tried to take a little bit of space out of Nyla's room, so it didn't seem like she had like all this space. But the weirdest thing about her room is that it is long instead of wide, so it made things a little bit harder to fit in. I had to do a lot of adjusting and a lot of pre-thinking before I started, because I was like, oh god, it's gonna be really, really hard to fit all this stuff in. Because you can see, even I think in this part in particular, I had a lot of long pauses because I was like, dude, I don't know what the heck to do. Is it gonna be really difficult to kind of figure out exactly what to do with this? I don't know. But anyways, so I am just adding in some black. I was gonna copy Malik's room sort of, but then I realized I really didn't like it in her room just because hers is kind of long and his is wider, so he has more space to fit things. So I kind of had to take the space that I had in her room into account. So I found this really pretty black shelf, which I decided to add. And then I also, a pretty black drawer, whatever, it's technically a drawer. And then I added the shelves like I have in everybody else's rooms. And then I also tried to add some flowers and stuff and just kind of make her room very expressive. Honestly, I feel like this room would have probably fit Maya a little bit more until I started adding in the books. Then I was like, okay, this is definitely Nyla's, very, very Nyla-ish. But yeah, so right now I'm adding in a bunch of flowers. I had a lot of butterfly posters and just a lot of cute little things. And then here I'm trying to figure out if I want to add a desk in, and I actually ended up just deciding to do it. I pretty much just copied the desk from Maya and Kraylin's room because I just felt like it would look a little bit better. So I added that in, and then I also put in the little lights here. I pretty much just copied their look, but just put it in her room because I just felt like it was a really nice way to form the desk. So I wanted to copy it. But then I realized, as I said, the same issue is that Nyla has such a long room instead of wide. So it kind of all looked like it was smushed together, and I couldn't figure out how to make it look like it wasn't so smushed. So everything is very, very close knit. And I don't know if she's gonna struggle to get in the room, but I guess we'll see once I start recording the episode. But hopefully she can get in the room no problem. We'll see. But I'm adding in the final bits of the poster, and I think that is it for this room furnishing. Let me know in the comments down below which room was your favorite. I'll go ahead and add a poll on this video. You guys can let me know which room you like the best and which room you would personally live in. But anyways, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. I love you guys all so, so very much, and I will see you on Tuesday for my very next video. Bye, guys.